I, for one, would love to see more athletes keep their mouths shut, especially when they're at less than 60% effort. But if you say only nasal breathing should be done, then I would say you've never worked that hard, right? Because if you put your feet to the fire in whatever way, that can mean a really intense CrossFit workout. Like if you really do, the most famous CrossFit workout, which is Fran, and you put your ass into it and you go, and you really test yourself, there's no way for 99% of us you're going to keep your mouth closed because it's going to be too close to our potential work rate. Now, there's going to be some outliers like CrossFit Games athletes whose total range, their total potential for work is so far beyond what that workout can test anymore that they can do it nasal only and still go very fast because their total work potential is so much higher. But for average folks like, me and you and most people who just CrossFit for health and fitness and fun, Fran is a fantastic test of intensity. And it's not likely you're gonna, if you're really using it as a test of intensity, you're probably not gonna keep your mouth closed. But that said, there's other workouts where you could do really great, like for example, Murph. If you can learn to pace yourself with nasal work while you're doing Murph, or especially this time of year, it's almost March. The real diehards start doing Murph prep in like the next 2 weeks, right? They start running and they're doing little Cindy variations all the time. I remember from being in the gym, guys are like, oh, it's March. Murph's come in, they start talking about what their training plan's going to be, which is great. I think it's cool that people, they have a goal, they have an aim. There's way worse things to spend your time thinking about and doing than, hey, how we're going to, as a community, attack our fitness test, right? It's good on them. Happy to see it. Actually, a good friend of mine, Dr. Brian Hickey, he has a really fantastic, if anybody wants to see a breakdown of Murph from the viewpoint of an exercise scientist, if you go to YouTube and you look up Dr. Brian Hickey and just put Murph, he does a breakdown of how to approach Murph from an exercise science standpoint, and it's fantastic. Like, hey, in this aerobic part in the runs, you should be thinking about this. You can nasal breathe here, you can start opening your mouth. This is more lactic driven. It's really cool. If you're like a CrossFit nerd, you bug on it. It's pretty fun. But yeah, I mean, I think that the conversation about nasal breathing is important and it has to be had because so much dysfunction comes out of not doing it. But if you're talking about athletes, and you're working with a 100-meter sprinter and you ask them to keep their mouth closed while they're doing their event, no bueno. It's not going to happen. It's the demands of the environment are just too high. But that said, there's other things they can do with their mouths closed that will center them and improve their performance and dial them in. So it still has valid. It's just, and that's really up to the coach, is to understand the tool and then to use the tool appropriately, right?
Right, like get them into the right state, like arousal level before they actually go into the event, even if their event itself, is gonna be mouth breathing, for example.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And you can use it as a conditioning tool. So, at a seminar I did last year, one of Usain Bolt's coaches was there, and they were talking about, they came up to me because I have a slide with him on it, and they were like, hey, he tapes his mouth all off season when he's doing his sprints, and then as he starts to do higher intensity, they let him open his mouth up. But when he's trying to build his conditioning to so that he can do more reps on the track, mouth closed. It's harder, it acts like a governor,
Right.
but it builds up a lot of resilience. And sometimes it's good for it to act like a governor. So it's a very clever coaching tool you can use when you want to slow yourself, or if you're a coach, an athlete down, if you just want them to, like if you have somebody who's stubborn and doesn't know how to drop it to 60%, and you're like, man, I really actually need a 60% work rate from this person today or from myself, You can just self-impose, I'm keeping my mouth closed, and it'll force you to go slower. And then as a result, like, oh, I'll do less damage to my soft tissues. I like won't get as sore, and I won't beat my joints up today. So it's a great way to self-govern, or it's a wonderful tool if you're a coach, for sure.